Hello and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox on the Series X, and this is a bonus video as a test. In a way, I'm trying out some new recording software. Actually, I've gone up market. I'm not using Twitch anymore, so this is a quick tutorial on the event controller. So I'm just going to build a little platform here out in the ice lake. I'll give you an example of what the event controller settings are and what it does. So if we move across here and we pop in a battery and another battery, and then we go in here to our programmable block. We can then shoot up here until we get to our event controller, spin it round, and there it is. So the event controller is used to monitor states of certain blocks, such as a cockpit or a seat. If a seat is entered, do a thing. If a door is opened, do a thing. So let's take an example like this. Go into the event controller and you'll see it has numerous events. You have all the way from the top, altitude, angle, block added and removed, block integrity, block on off, switched, cargo filled, cockpit occupied, connector connected, connector ready to lock, distance to locked targets, door opened, and so on. All of these here. And with these, what we can do is we can set up an if-then. So if thing is true, do one thing. If thing is not true, do another. So let's take an example from a door. One thing that people have always sort of wanted to do on Space Engineers is set up doors that auto close. Well, normally you'd have a timer block, basically, on a loop, and that would be literally ticking through constantly, you know, taking up CPU cycles. In this case, what we can do is we can set up a timer block like this, and we want this timer block after about, oh, I don't know, 6 seconds or so. We want this timer block to take our sliding door and close it. So when we start our timer block, after 6 seconds, it shuts the door. So now what we want is we want that to shut that when we open it after 6 seconds. This is where the event controller comes in. So if you go to your event controller and you just go here, and what you want to pick is door opened. And then what you need to do is you need to come down. You need to find the sliding door right here. And you want to add blocks to the sliding door. So you want to add sliding door. And that sliding door is being now monitored by the event controller. So we want to select actions and we want to put on the true part, or the first box, as it were, that's the true statement. So if true, start timer block. Now, in theory, if this has worked, I open the door, the timer block starts. 6 seconds later, the door closes. And we don't need the false action. So now we have an automatic closing door without the need for a timer block to be constantly ticking away. In other words, you're not going to go to a door and that door is not going to slam in your face when you try to open it. And there you go. That is how you can set up a really simple use of the event controller to make a door close automatically. Hopefully that's been of some use to you. This is a test, as I said, of a brand new way of doing these videos. And if it's successful and if it's worked out, then I will probably switch to this for the foreseeable future, because it seems that the issue with Twitch is going to be long term. So until then, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. That's all from me for now. Oh, and one final word, actually. A big thank you to Erin Truitt, hopefully I've said that correct, of Keen Software, who put me onto this. So cheers, or Kienata, as he likes to be known. Bye for now.